Welcome friends. Thank you for joining Ego E-Learning. Myself Dr. Sonal Desai. I'm here to introduce you about second video of OpenStudio Energy Modeling Software using EnergyPlus. And we know that OpenStudio is GUI of EnergyPlus, and in our first module we have learned about basic of EnergyPlus and OpenStudio. We have seen how to add weather file, how to add design day file, how to draw a basic model, and how to perform a basic simulation. So going ahead in a second module with further information about how to decide space types, how to add load to the system, and how to have ideal air load to be added. So here is an introduction about what is the content of this second module of this OpenStudio energy simulation software. As just said, this video is about thermal loads and energy uses. Thermal load is basically a load which is added to the building, and how this software caters this load, that is discussed in this video series. A building end use may consume energy directly as well as indirectly. There are direct energy consumption, like there is a lighting system used, there are some electrical equipment used, like there is a use of laptop, computer and all. Then there are some gas equipments. So this types of load, they add direct load as well as indirect load. Indirect load is in terms of heat input to be added to the HVAC system. Then another source of thermal loading is human occupancy. Human being add sensible as well as latent heat load. So how this load is added in OpenStudio software, that we will see in this video modules. Also, there is consideration of infiltration of air, that is outside air entering to the building. So how that is being considered. And lastly, there is also mention about what is thermal mass and how to consider it. So there is a diagram in front of you that shows that how different types of load act on the building. The building is thermally connected with the upper floor as well as with the side of the wall. Hence, there is no heat loads across these two boundaries, but it is connected to atmosphere through this phase. And on this phase, there exists one window. So there will be solar heat loss, heat addition or heat loss based on the weather and based on the location. Also, there will be equipment loading to the room, like there will be heating equipment, then that load will be there. All other electric gadgets, they will be adding sensible heat load. Human being, that will add sensible and latent heat load. So all this consideration is shown in this module. Then how different loads are considered, what is a schedule, how scheduling is done, and how this cumulative load applied to the space, that is discussed in this video series. Schedule is basically deciding occupancy of the building, and we know that schedule keeps on varying based on time of the day as well as the day of the week or a week of the month, and accordingly scheduling difference will be there. So what is schedule and how to draw the schedule in OpenStudio, that is part of this module. Different load definitions and their categorization is there. So some images are there in this introduction video to make you understand what is OpenStudio working methodology. Here, this is schedule set, different types of schedule sets we are going to learn over here, like occupancy schedule, that is a fractional type of schedule, or there can be a thermostat schedule, which is controlling temperatures, or there can be lighting schedule, which is again kind of fraction type of schedule, or there can be other types of gas equipment or water equipment schedule. So we are going to learn different schedule set. And the schedules will be something like this, that how much, if it is a fractional schedule, then with respect to day of the 24-hour a day, how much occupancy is there with respect to duration of the time, that we are going to see. Also, how to consider the time of the year, like for all 365 days, if some inoccupancy is there, like educational institute is there which will not be working for a few vacation days. So we may define them, or we may also define holidays, we may also define weekends and weekdays. So that is what a scheduling is, and how to do this scheduling, that is shown in this video series. Then this is the image of showing lighting densities. So how to define lighting density, and how the model understand it in terms of radiant fraction and fractional visible fraction. Similarly, how to consider other loads like human loads, or how to consider a water equipment load, people load, that is discussed over here. Then comes infiltration, which is basically outside air entering to the room. It is of basically two type. One is design one, and second is the one which is entering through leakages. So three different categorization of this infiltered air is there, and they are explained in this video series. Then comes different load to be added to the space. So that method is shown. And finally, there comes report generation. So how to generate the report by running the simulation, and how to interpret those reports. Like this report shows how much energy consumption is there for lighting and for interior equipment, that is shown. In this module, we have not yet applied HVAC. So it is not considering HVAC. It is just considering lighting and human load. And there is monthly, annual overview of the reports are discussed. Then how many days of the year are falling in which particular temperature zone, that is there. There is a facility to view outcomes in a DView software. So that is also a part of this video series. How to set thermostat loads, and how to see basic ideal air load, and to see the performance after adding it. So you can see over here now cooling and heating are depicted. So that is explained. And there is a change in monthly overview that is also shown over here. So this course is definitely helpful if you are an engineer, if you are working on a building plan, or if you are working with OpenStudio or EnergyPlus, then this is a must-go course for you. Please join for the course. Thank you for watching.